Today, I am gonna talk about the application of a dot product. As you know, dot product formula or two vectors, vector u and vector v, dot product u dot v, magnitude of u times magnitude of v times cosine theta. Between these two vectors, so these two vectors tail to tail. So based on this information, I would like to show you and this problem. Problem says calculate the work done by the gravity as the box, this box slides to the bottom of the ramp. So box slides comes here. So we ignore the friction. Normally in real life there is always friction, but because of we need to understand the concept, we just ignore the friction. So before to do the calculation, I want to do, so this is the displacement from here to here, 12 meter. So when I look this triangle, this is a right triangle. So X will be, so this is theta slope 26 degree, so adjacent over hypotenuse, so X will be 12 times cosine 26, so 1079. So this is Y from here to here, this is opposite, so it will be 12 times sine 26 equal 526 meter. So we can also, so this is the mass of the box. So from Newton formula we know force on the box, gravitational force on the box, mass times gravitational field strength. So mass 24.5 kilogram, gravitational field strength on the surface of the earth 9.8 newton per kilogram. So when we multiply this we get 240 newton. So I just find the component, I may need this information. So two components, one component parallel to the surface, another component perpendicular to the surface. So I will call this FG parallel, FG perpendicular. This is FG. It is going center of the earth. So after I calculate FG, FG perpendicular. So basically this is right triangle again. This is 26 degree given slope. So this is 90 minus 26. So this is rectangular. So this is 90 degree. 90 minus 64, 26 degree. Basically this triangle and this triangle are similar triangle. So FG perpendicular 240 times cosine 26, FG parallel 240 times sine 26. We get those calculation. So work will be the scalar quantity. This is not vector quantity. So work will be force dot displacement. Yes, force dot displacement. So first of all, I basically in physics there are also these kind of problems, but in grade 12 textbooks they do slightly different. But here I want to show you how to use dot product. So we can do FG dot D one way. So FG force vector, D is the displacement vector. So I take dot product of this Fg, we calculated 240 dot, so 12 times cosine 64. So I just want to remind you dot product again, u dot v, magnitude of u times magnitude of v, then cosine theta. So angle in between these two vectors. So when I work on this, when I calculate, we get 1263 joules. So there is no direction, scalar. We can do this way also. D, vector D, so from here to here, box is going. So this y component, this is x component. So let's say you can go from here to here, you can go also from here to here. So basically, this D will be y plus x or x plus y. Now normally we write x first. So when I replace D by x plus y, so I get Fg dot x plus y. So I can do this way also. Gx dot plus Fg y dot. So we get this Fgx because Fg and x perpendicular, 0, the second one will be 1263 equal 0 plus 12 1263 joules. So we get same number. I can do also like this. Fg parallel dot D. This is Fg parallel, the green one. D this one. So basically same direction. What is Fg parallel? 105 21, D 12. So cosine 0. When I do calculation, I get 1263 joules. Again, if I replace D x plus y as I did here, D equal x plus y. So Fg parallel dot x plus y, so I replace D Fg parallel. Okay, so Fg parallel dot x plus Fg parallel dot y. So when I do this calculation, I get 1020. Second part, I get 243 1263 joules. So I didn't show the detailed calculation, this one and this one. This is in fact not necessary, but just to show you the concept of the calculation. Basically, D is a vector, one vector, but component of this, so basically y, so instead of going from here to here, you can go here, then come here. That is what I did here. So there is not one method, there are several methods. As I told you before, dot product, scalar quantity, basically it gives number, returns a number. So work also scalar quantity. Basically work is the change of kinetic energy in physics textbook. It is explained this way. So energy also scalar quantity. Yeah, so I hope this will help. Thank you very much.